This really is a pileup at the four-way intersection of identity politics here. So
really?
What that clip does not reveal is that one of the people who called for Nancy Pelosi to maybe step aside at the age of 77 is Linda Sanchez of California, who's, of course, a female Latina Democrat.
Right.
So here you have some guy telling a woman that she's a sexist for criticizing Nancy Pelosi. I'm losing track of who's got privilege here. How does this work?
Right. Well, I mean, we're not saying Linda Sanchez isn't necessarily right because she's a Latino woman for saying that.
I agree.
I mean, yes, and maybe others are sexist when it comes to Nancy Pelosi. So I do believe that. I think he is correct there. I don't think Linda Sanchez necessarily was sexist by saying what she said. Maybe jealous. I mean, Nancy Pelosi is a pioneer. She's a powerful woman. Who knows? Maybe she's a little jealous.
Well, look, I'm not the kind of guy who traffics in epithets like sexist. But it's conforming a bit to a stereotype for you, don't you think, with respect, to suggest that Linda Sanchez is jealous? Like one woman looks upon another woman's success and is jealous?
I mean,
that kind of a gender stereotype,
no? Well, no, it just doesn't make sense. Nancy Pelosi is not a liability. Her caucus supports her. Why would she be there? She would not be there if she were a liability. So Linda Sanchez's comments make no sense whatsoever. So I can't imagine.
Look, it's not my fight. I'm not a fight, but here, I mean, I'm not a Democrat, so have fun. But here are the numbers, and maybe this is part of the reason. So after the 2006 election, it was, midway through Bush's second term, Democrats retook the House, Pelosi became Speaker. That year, they had 233 seats in the House of Representatives. A lot has happened since Donald Trump got elected, and now Democrats have 194 seats in the House. That's a massive and historic loss. Meanwhile, Democrats have lost over 1,000 seats across the country with Pelosi as the most visible leader of their party. So maybe just by the numbers, that suggests abject failure.
But the numbers also do show that politics can be quite sexist. We have this nation has 51% women, yet we're 20% of Congress, 20% in the House, 20% in the Senate. So now we have 23 cabinet members. We have four that are women, less than ever, half than we had with President Obama. So the numbers are showing that women are not necessarily making huge strides in Washington, D.C. This is not a great time.
Interesting.
In D.C.
Yeah.
In D.C.
Luckily, electoral success is not the only measure of success, thank God. But and I'm sure it's a very complicated thing. I mean, there are a lot of reasons for what you just described.
Right, but D.C. is testosterone-filled right now. There's no denying that.